Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. This is a video in my declutter series. I have filmed this in 2017, so I know it's not going up before 2018, but this is the intro for every video, so if you have seen it before, that's why. I've used the same intro for every video. And a main thing in this declutter series is that I'm not getting rid of a lot, but I have accumulated a big bag that I have now given to friends and family, and my three cousins really really loved it, and my mom and my aunt actually got some too. So I have a bit left, and that is the items that are too dark for my friends and family. So I just need to find the right person and give it to her, but they will not be counted in my makeup inventory that I am going to do after the series. And if you want a makeup collection tour or setup or something, please let me know down below. So yeah, this is my declutter series. I hope you enjoy, and please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on all of the videos I have planned out. And yeah, please like, comment and subscribe, and then I will see you next time. Bye guys. Okay, let's get through it. This is my big eyeshadow palette collection. You know, it's not big, but it's too big. I love my eyeshadow. I'm an eyeshadow junkie. I'm not getting rid of much, but I know some palettes in here that I am going to get rid of, just because it's not me and I rather want better quality eyeshadows in the future. I think maybe my cousins will like them and stuff like that. These are all my W7 palettes. I know for a fact I really really enjoy these two, the eye cushions, the Stylite and the Dreamer. I have used this a ton. This is brand new, so I'm going to keep these ones just because I really really like the formula of these. I really like this one. It is the Night on the Tour palette. This is the dupe for the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. And this is beautiful. I love it so much. So never in life I'm getting rid of this one. Oh my god. Let's talk about these two. This is the W7 in the buff, and this is the W7 Eye Echo. If I open them up, I want you to tell me the difference down below for these two palettes. The only difference is that I have used this one and I haven't with this one. They are identical. They just have different packaging. Why? I don't know. So I'm keeping my used one, the Inter Buff one, and then I'm getting rid of my Eye Echo one for my cousins because I have never touched it. So yep, getting rid of one. I'm really on the fence about these ones. And the Goldiebugs one, it looks like this in the buff one that I just kept very very much. It's very neutral. I'm never going to get through that many neutrals, but I really do like that shade right there. And okay, these shades are very very nice. But these and these looks quite identical to some of the pans in this one. So I'm not going to keep it, even though I'm going to be so sad about these four, five shades of people. So pretty. I can always get it because it's very inexpensive, and yeah. Then I have these two. I really considered panning these in 2018. This is an all matte palette. It is the Mighty Mattes Neutral Nudes. But I just kept my smaller version of this, the Inter City one. This is a white shade, so that is very very good. These ones look identical. This is a more pinky one, okay, but these looks the same, and then these is slightly different. So I'm not going to hold on to that, even though I actually thought about panning it next year because it's neutral. But no. I think it's a good palette for beginners or something like that, so I'm going to give that away. I have this lip palette. I know Rebecca from, oh my god, what is your username? Panning with me? Panning with P- Rebecca? Okay, I can't remember. Something panning. I'm so sorry, Rebecca. I adore you and your panning skills. She panned an entire Urban Decay lip palette in 2017, and I admire that so much, and I know how hard it was. But I really, really like these shades. These are so, like metallic shades, and these are more matte shades. They are beautiful nudes. I really, really love them. I'm not going to give it away, but I will try to work on it next year because I know how hard it is to go through them. Let's go through these ones. I'm not going to get rid of any of these. This is my The Bon Bon Jovi palette. I'm so in love with this palette overall. The design, the shadows, the highlighter and blush. And there is some cream blushes down here that also can be used on the lips. I'm not getting rid of this. I love it too much to get rid of it, so it is staying. This is the Too Faced Chocolate Bar. This is obviously staying if you have seen my panda palette intro. These two and this one is my oldest palettes in my collection. With my Vice 4, I will show you in a minute. And this is my Nils Shore Eyeshadow 3 Symphony something. It is beautiful. The eyeshadows are amazing. I have not used them since like spring or something, but fall last year, but they are beautiful and I am totally keeping these ones. And then my The Balm Nude palette is beautiful neutral, so I'm going to keep that one. Then I have these three palettes. This is actually one that was supposed to go into my face palettes in my blush and bronzer and highlighter declutter. But I'm going to keep this one. I need to use it more, so that is my goal next year, to use it a bit more. Spend a lot of money on these Urban Decay Gwen Stefani palettes. So I'm not going to get rid of them. Even though I'm not the biggest fan of these eyeshadows, they are very much the same. But I do like them a lot. And this one is not going anywhere as well. It is my BH Cosmetics Shen YNXO collab with the eyeshadows and then the lip products on the back. These are not going anywhere. So, this is my bigger eyeshadow palettes, my two Morphe palettes. It's not going anywhere. I have the 35K and the 35OM. They are beautiful. So this is the 35K. It is a big neutral. I love them so much. I really, really do. And my OM is amazing because me and Orange, oh my god, this is heaven. And if I could choose again, I would just pick the 35O because there's shimmer in it. But these are amazing shadows and I will never change them in the world or give them away or anything. Then we have my W7 paint box. I just got this like 1 or 2 months ago. And it's actually pretty good. I was kind of surprised because the shadows didn't seem that pigmented or anything, but they are so good beginner palettes. It has a bunch of neutrals, some purples, blues, greens, grays, so you can make smoky eyes. So I'm going to give this to one of my cousins or something that really are going to get into eyeshadow or something. I'm going to get rid of this, but this was amazing. It really was, but I'm not going to use it in a video or anything. This is not going anywhere at all. This is my Vice 4 palette. I did a palette bingo of this and I fell in love once more. This is amazing. This is so beautiful. I considered doing a palette bingo on it again, but I just love the rainbow thingy and it is amazing. So even though I'm only getting rid of 4 bigger palettes, I'm really excited about it because eyeshadows are they're all W7. Yeah. Even though it's only 4 palettes, I'm pretty excited about it because eyeshadow is my love. It is my favorite thing about makeup ever. Even though I have kept a lot of palettes, I'm not mad at all. I'm actually pretty excited about getting rid of these two and this one as well. This was the only one I had planned getting rid of. And the only two I'm so about is these two, but I have a plan for these.